Simon & Schuster Audio presents Megatrends Asia, 8 Asian Megatrends that are reshaping our world. Written and introduced by John Nesbitt. Read by Jesse Boggs.
The first time I went to Asia, I stayed a year. That was in 1967. On leave from IBM, I was advising the Royal Government of Thailand on agricultural growth, dividing my time between Bangkok and Nong Khai, which is directly across the mighty Mekong River from Vientiane, the capital of Laos. Occasionally, I'd hire some local people to row me in one of their longboats to the other side, to Vientiane, a distance of almost a mile. Today, on that very spot, there's a gleaming new $42 million bridge between Nong Khai and Vientiane, a symbol of the economic progress that has been made in Thailand. For me, it is also a symbol of the progress that has been made in all of Asia. This progress and the momentum behind it constitutes by far the most important development in the world today. Nothing else comes close. Not only for Asians, but for the entire planet. The modernization of Asia will forever reshape the world as we move toward the next millennium. In the 1990s, Asia came of age, and as we move toward the year 2000, Asia will become the dominant region of the world, economically, politically, and culturally. We are on the threshold of an Asian renaissance. And if you have any doubts about the speed at which this mega shift is happening, keep listening. Your doubts will be erased one by one. You'll hear about all 30 countries in the region, but you'll hear most about China, Hong Kong, India, Indonesia, Japan, South Korea, Malaysia, the Philippines, Singapore, Taiwan, Thailand, and Vietnam. That's where the most dynamic growth and change is located. The Asian Renaissance is not a change the world will readily accept, but it is time to face reality and to devise a strategy to adapt to it. The old Asia was divided by culture, language, political ideology, religious philosophies, and geography, but a new commonwealth of nations based on economic integration is emerging in the East, the Asian Commonwealth. For the first time in their long history, the nations of the region are working together for mutual economic gain, and the catalyst is the free market. The new Asia, forged by economic integration, technology, travel and mobility of people, and especially telecommunications, will increasingly look like one coherent region. The Asian continent, from India to Japan, from below the old Soviet Union down to Indonesia, now accounts for more than half the world's population. Within 5 years or less, more than half of these Asian households will be able to buy an array of consumer goods, refrigerators, television sets, washing machines, computers, cosmetics, and more. And as many as a half billion people will become what the West calls middle class. That market is roughly the size of the United States and Europe combined. As the widely placed Hong Kong Bank ad says, there are 3 billion people in Asia, half of them under 25. Consider it a growing market. This is a consumer miracle holding vast economic consequences. 50 years from now, it will be clear that the most momentous global development of the 1990s and the early part of the next century was the modernization of Asia. It is the astonishing end result of the 8 major shifts taking place in the region today. Later on this tape, we'll give details of all 8, but here they are in brief. First, There's a critical shift in Asia from nation states to networks. Japan's economic dominance has reached its apex, and its relative economic position in Asia and the world is on a long downward slide. In time, it will be not China itself, but the network of overseas Chinese that will dominate the region. Second is the shift from traditions to options. In Asia, the notion of predestination is being replaced by diversity and a new individualism. This has bottom-line consequences. Here's an example. While the West is locked into welfare state burdens, the new Asia will have many options. The third is the shift from export-led to consumer-driven economies. Built on exports, Asian economies will increasingly be fueled by consumer spending and with it an emerging middle class. By the year 2000, Asia will have almost a half a billion people who are what we generally understand as middle class. The fourth is the change from government-controlled to market-driven economies in Asia. Central government control and direction of economies of the region have shifted to market economies, leading to an explosion of economic growth and opportunities. This shift has been accompanied by unprecedented economic cooperation and coordination among the countries of Asia. The fifth shift is from farms to super cities. Migration from rural areas of Asia to its cities is taking place at an astonishing pace. This social shift is transforming Asia, moving it to a new era of development, away from agricultural societies to ones where cultural diversity and expanded opportunities will dominate. Sixth is from labor-intensive production to high technology. In Asia, we are witnessing a dramatic shift from labor-intensive agriculture and manufacturing to state-of-the-art technology in manufacturing and services. This is most pronounced in the rush to computers and telecommunications. Seventh is from male dominance to the emergence of women. The shift from male dominance is most apparent in the increase of women entrepreneurs throughout Asia. In China, women make up 25% of all entrepreneurs. Women as voters, consumers, and members of the workforce are now participating in all aspects of Asian life in unprecedented ways. And the eighth is from West to East. The world used to mean the Western world. Today, global trends are forcing us to confront a reality, the rise of the East. It is becoming apparent to the East and to some in the West that we are moving towards the Asianization of the world. Asia was once the center of the world, and now the center is again returning to Asia. So, those are the eight Asian megatrends that are reshaping the world. For the Chinese, the number eight is a very lucky number. Some people in Hong Kong pay hundreds of dollars to get an eight on their license plate or in their phone number. These eight trends will certainly bring luck to Asia. They will lead to an unprecedented prosperity. But how will they affect the West? Western nations long competed complacently among themselves until Japan suddenly took the field. We are now confronted by not just another player, but by a powerful new team of nations, and whether win, lose, or draw, or whether everybody comes out a winner, will depend on how well we know the competition and how well we play the game.
For so many years, it was the Japanese. The Japanese are coming. It appeared they were going to dominate the world economically. But now...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, Use the link in the video description.